Hi, and welcome back to SoFlo Dining, South Florida's premier dining blog. I'm Chef Dan, and this is Doris with a D.
Hi, welcome back.
Welcome back. In this edition, we're going to talk to you about Ciao Amore. Ciao Amore is located in Lauderdale by the Sea.
Mm-hmm. And tell everybody how you heard about this place.
How we heard about it. We've been getting a lot of recommendations for Ciao Amore from some pretty reliable people. Mm-hmm. And they've been on the list for a while. And, the turd came up.
And by reliable people, he means listeners. Like
yes,
you guys.
Followers like you guys,
yes,
right.
Thank you.
We rely on your input, whether it's Facebook, whether it's SoFloDining.com, whether it's, TikTok,
anything. Doesn't matter where, yeah.
Instagram. We read it all. And, it's just a matter of time. Just because something you put in didn't come up real quick, It's on the list. Yeah. Yep. So anyway, back to Ciao Amore.
Yes. So where is it located?
Okay, it's located in Lauderdale by the Sea.
Mm-hmm. Plenty of parking?
I think it's about 3 or 4 blocks from the ocean, from the center of Lauderdale by the Sea. So it's some walking distance of everything.
Right.
Yep.
And on way commercial. Before the bridge.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Just so you know. Yep. So what was your first impression in seating?
First impression in seating? Okay. Seating, I know they have seating outside, seating inside.
Mm-hmm.
We went inside. Valentina greeted us.
Yes.
And
graciously.
It was just so quaint. So, you felt like you were going into somebody's kitchen almost. Right?
Yeah.
Like somebody's own... dining
someone's,
room.
Yeah, someone's on home.
Very welcoming.
Uh-huh. What about the menu options and variety?
Menu options, okay. It's very Italian. Your typical, your fare, mm-hmm. Italian fare.
Right.
What else? Menu options, it's yes. Pretty much, you have your standard chicken, your beef,
Yeah, your vitello and all that other good stuff.
Right.
Yeah. So what about the drinks and service?
Drinks and service. Okay, drinks, we didn't have any drinks. I think we just had club soda, water.
Uh-huh.
Service was excellent. Again, we had Valentina.
Uh-huh.
And even there was a lull where she actually came over and talked to us.
Oh, yeah.
And gave you a little history of the family, the cheese business.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes. And that's where we found out about the terrific burrata.
Okay, for appetizer, we had the burrata.
Mm-hmm.
The burrata, I think, had to be probably one of my top 3 burratas that I've ever had. I mean, it was delicious. I loved it.
Yes.
Yeah, but then when she spoke to us and told us about it, why don't you tell them?
Well, yes, they have another store,
yeah.
Which is where her husband makes the cheese. And they also have breakfast and lunch there.
Right, so they have another store down on Commercial in Fort Lauderdale,
mm-hmm.
where they focused on breakfast and lunch. They make the cheeses daily there.
Mm-hmm.
They have pizza, sandwiches, stuff like that. We probably will be reviewing them in the future. So, but just so you don't get confused, we're talking about the one in Lauderdale by the Sea.
Right, for dinner.
Exactly.
And so, your overall impression?
From there, you had the lasagna.
Oh, yeah.
Mm.
Sorry about that.
Overall impression.
Overall impression was, is it awesome?
You had the lasagna, which was out of this world. I loved it, how it was served in its own little ramekin thing.
Mm-hmm, like grandma used to make.
And I had, again, if you don't know this by now, I'm a sucker for horchetta, broccoli rabe, and sausage.
There you go.
I had that.
The Trinity.
Wow. Yeah. I made sure I saved some so I could have some for the next day.
Yes.
Along with your leftover lasagna.
Yes. Yes, and I got into your horchetta also.
Both were delicious.
So what was your overall impression?
Overall impression, I really liked the place. I really recommend it. If you were staying in Lauderdale by the Sea or if you live near Lauderdale by the Sea, check them out.
I forgot about the grandma cake.
Oh, yeah. Well, you're going to love it. She forgot about the grandma cake, so we're going to get back with the overall impression.
Dessert.
recommendations. I'm going to tell you, your cheddar, broccoli, rabe, and sausage. But save room for the grandma cake. The homemade grandma cake is delicious.
Mm-hmm.
We
all of their pastries are delicious.
Pre-taping, we were talking about desserts and stuff. And I said, not a pet peeve, but something I give people guidance on. So many restaurants have the same desserts, the chocolate cake, the key lime, the ice cream, whatever. You could have that anywhere. When somebody offers you homemade grandma cake or homemade their special cake, go with it.
Yeah.
I mean, this is their grandmother's recipe. They're proud of this. So you know this is going to be good.
It's tried and true.
Right. You know it's going to be good. So one of my recommendations, save room for the grandma cake because it is.
Or take it home.
It's delicious. Yeah. It's delicious.
Seriously.
So as always, enjoy and we'll see you there.
Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
And don't forget to let them know that your friends at SoFlo Dining sent you.
That's right.
And like Dora says, always, please subscribe. It's very important. Mm-hmm. It keeps us relevant.
Thank you again.
Yep. Take care. Bye.
Bye.